In June, a group of Australian and international scientists and regulators of agricultural and veterinary chemicals came together in Queensland for a three-day workshop on spray drift reducing technologies. Back in 2010, spray drift became an even greater priority for Australia's regulators and the wider agricultural community when the national regulatory body, the Australian Pesticides and Veterinary Medicines Authority, implemented a policy requiring all new pesticides be assessed for potential risk of spray drift. As a result, labels on newly registered products can contain mandatory no spray zones with an option to review older products.
Welcome to the University of Queensland Gatton campus.
As part of the three-day workshop, the group came here to see firsthand some of the latest drift reducing technology, or DRTs. An opportunity the workshop's organiser believes will result in better informed decisions relating to no spray or downwind buffer zones.
The working party will be working with the regulator to ensure that DRTs are recognised and credited in the regulatory system, so that anybody using best technologies and best practice will be rewarded by a shorter buffer zone.
The National Working Party for Pesticide Application was set up by agricultural industries to make sure the regulators would have hard scientific data to use in their decision-making process. And GRDC has been funding research into DRTs to provide the relevant data. Research such as Andrew Hewitt's work on spray droplet size and how it's impacted by nozzle type and application variables such as release height, speed and prevailing weather.
What we do is we measure these things under controlled conditions in wind tunnels, and then we repeat that work in the field and we understand how we can change the performance of the spray based on the nozzle, the spray mix, the weather, height of the boom, all of these kind of things that an applicator can control and have a very real impact on how good his spraying job is.
Already this research data has resulted in one spray manufacturer reducing the size of its recommended buffer zones, according to Andrew Hewitt.
Chemical companies, when they formulate, now as a result of this work, they're able to make their formulations drift far less. And we're now looking at buffers, we've heard this week from one particular company, that are one-fifth the size they were before this work started.
The data being produced is being collated into reference libraries, used in computer modelling, and all of it is intended for the development of better drift-reducing technologies.
Yes, very much so. We have a model now called WT-DISP. The WT stands for wind tunnel. So all the data generated in this wind tunnel doing that research feeds into this model, which can then provide valuable information to the regulators and to anyone else who's interested, of course.
There was plenty more for the group to see, but the opportunity to spend a little time visiting what's regarded in the research community as a world-class project was very valuable.
Well, I guess the regulators are very good at interpreting scientific papers, so it was interesting then for them to see the mechanics of how we actually go about doing it.
On a nearby airstrip was another example of drift-reducing technology not seen every day. And for more on that, follow the link to the second part of this report.